Morning, everyone, and welcome to South Africa for the start of this titanic struggle. In fact, another day in this titanic struggle. I use the word titanic because at the moment that's what this country is, a wreck. The South African government has been in now for a little over 75 years, and I must say that there doesn't seem to be any sign of an early declaration by Captain Botha. Botha, strong right arm, square head, two short legs, so short, in fact, that he hasn't got a leg to stand on. Botha, making a surprise move to dismiss the pass laws, superb piece of hypocrisy that, I thought, offering to dismiss a law that should never have been allowed in the first place. What we call in Australia, a fair suck of the sauce bottle. As for the bowling out there today, Thatcher's performance, quite a bit of indecision here from the Iron Maiden, I thought. She was completely stumped and still holds the record for no balls. As for the field play today, it's been very erratic. A couple of people dropped early on out of police station windows. As for the Man of the Series award, I think my nomination would go to the man who we caught a glimpse of on a hospital video last night, Nelson Mandela. Despite having his bail removed countless times, he's continued superbly to sweep the government beyond the boundary in conditions basically as tough as a dead dingo's donger. He was ably backed up out there by his wife, Winnie, whose refusal to be caught out is making Botha look pretty pathetic. There it is then, the scorecard: South African population 30 million, voting population 2 million, all white. Disgraceful figures, those, by any standards. No wonder they keep moving the side screens so no one can see anything. Finally, the authorities' performance in the match. The police came in from the tear gas works end, left arm round the wicket, firearms over the wicket, and a lot of wild shots with a .303. With that kind of attack, the prospects for fair play, I'm afraid, look very bleak. The light also looking pretty bad out there. In fact, I should say I don't think I've ever seen a government in such a bad light. Quite frankly, that's not cricket. I shouldn't be at all surprised if before long we don't actually see the ashes of a whole nation.